If we're not discuss about applications of Gauss law, Gauss 6. First one, intensity of electric field due to an infinitely charged lamp wire. Now we are discussed the definition of linear charge density. What is the definition? Lambda is equal to Q by L. Unit length of charge of a conductor is known as linear charge density. Okay. Now, what is the aim? What is the question? Intensity of electric field due to an infinity charge long wire. Okay. Now, it is an infinity long wire and the charge is Q and linear charge density lambda. Already we know lambda is equal to Q by L. So again, now we consider infinite charge lambda wire. The charge means how much Q and linear charge density lambda. But the intensity of electric field, it is perpendicular to the wire. Actually, this is the direction of intensity of electric field. Now, for determination of intensity of electric field, we have constructed a Gaussian surface, cylindrical surface around the wire, that is A, B, C, D. It is Gaussian cylindrical surface. Okay, it is Gaussian cylindrical surface. For determination of E, we constructed a Gaussian cylindrical surface around the wire, that is A, B, C, D. It is known as Gaussian cylindrical surface. Now we observe AB surface area is DS1 and similarly CD surface area is DS2. Now here DS1 and DS2 are perpendicular to E symbol. These are perpendicular and perpendicular. But you know the definition of electric test, what is the formula? Then phi E is equal to EDS cos theta. EDS cos theta. D by E is equal to EDS cos theta. From the figure, AB surface area is DS1 and CD surface area DS2. These are perpendicular to E. These are perpendicular to E. From the figure, now we can write DS1 and DS2. These are perpendicular to E. Now, what is the meaning of perpendicular? The angle is 90 degrees. From this equation, what is the electric equation? Then D by E is equal to EDS cos theta. But theta means the angle between E and DS. Here, E and DS2 or E and DS are perpendicular to each other. The theta is equal to how much? 90. But cos 90 value, then D by E is equal to EDS cos 90. Cos 90 that is equal to 0, then d pi e is equal to 0. Now what happened? The electric flux is not passing through from this area. Which area? DS1 and DS2. No electric flux from this area. Which area? DS1 and DS2. But what about the electric flux? The electric flux is formed only ABCD is curves around the wire. That is the ABCD curved surface and that is the curved surface. Okay. If now we consider a small area on the ABCD curved surface, that is known as DS. Now we are observed. DS and E, these are parallel to each other. What is the area? This is the small area. We consider the small area of DS where on curved surface of D, Gaussian cylindrical surface. DS means this is the small area on. We consider small area of DS and where it is the Gaussian surface. Which surface? Vertical. So the curved surface of the Gaussian cylindrical surface is the DS. Now from the figure, E and DS are parallel to each other. parallel to each other. Parallel to each other. Now then, E parallel to DS. From the definition of electric plus D by E is equal to E DS cos theta. And then now we find the electric plus. The electric plus cos theta from this area. Which area? DS. DS is what is the formula? D by E is equal to E DS cos theta. E DS cos theta. But theta is equal, these are parallel to each other. Theta is equal to how much of the parallel, nothing but here, 0 degrees. Then cos 0, that is equal to 1. Then d by e, that is equal to e dx. It is the small electric plus cos inflow from this area. Which area? Ds area. But we want the total electric plus cos inflow from total Gaussian surface. The small electric plus is passing through from the small area is how much? D by E is equal to E ds. But we wanted total electric plus passing through the total Gaussian cylindrical surface. Now we do integration on both sides equation. Now integration over integral D by E is equal to over integral E ds. Now here derivative integration is cancelled. Remaining is what? Pi E. And is constant over integral ds derivative integration is cancelled. Finally, we get that equation, then pi e is equal to es. It is the equation 2. The pi means total electric plus is passing the total Gaussian cylindrical surface, then pi is equal to how much? Es. But what about the s? S means the surface area of Gaussian cylindrical surface. S means surface area of Gaussian cylindrical surface. What is the formula? Then S is equal to 2 pi r L. The length of the Gaussian surface L and radius is how much? Smaller than 2 pi r. Now the S is equal to 2 pi r. This equation is substituted into this equation number 3. Then equation 3 substituting in equation 2. Then we get the 5 V is equal to E. S means 2 pi or L. 2 pi r L. It is the equation number 3. Okay. Now, we find the total electric plus from the total Gaussian cylindrical surface. Okay. Now, next. What is the Gauss law? Now, the using the Gauss law, Gauss law application. What is the Gauss law? The pi e from Gauss law. What is the formula then? Pi e is equal to q by epsilon naught. It is the equation number 4. From 3 and 4. What happened? Here pi e and pi e. Now we can write e into 2 pi r l, that is equal to, what is the equation then? Q by epsilon naught. Here, LHS is one now, pi e, similarly, or it is also equal. Then e into 2 pi r, that is equal to q by L. From linear charge density, what is the formula? Lambda is equal to q by L. Already we are discussing, this is the formula, lambda is equal to q by L. Now, we do cross multiplication, then q is equal to lambda. Now, replace the q, what happened then? E into 2 pi over L, that is equal to q means lambda L by epsilon naught. Now L is in this cancel. We get final equation, then E is equal to, what is the formula? Lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught R. It is the intensity of electric field due to infinite charge lambda. Why? It is the important topic. You know, here from this equation, what is the lambda? Linear charge density. What is the r? The radius of the what is known up to the Gaussian cylindrical surface, E means intensity of electric field. No, okay, one second. What is the value? Intensity of electric field due to an infinite charged lamp using Gauss law. And we find the intensity of electric field due to an infinite charged lamp wire. Now we consider it is the a long straight pipe of charge Q and a linear charge density is a lambda. Okay? Now, if one of the intensity of electric field in which direction, it is perpendicular to the wire. Now we determination of the E. Now we are constructed with a Gaussian cylindrical surface around the wire. Of radius is how much R and length is what AB, that is ABCD. From the figure, AB surface area is what DS1 and CD surface area is what DS2. These are perpendicular to E. Now we are observed DS2 perpendicular to E. Well, similarly, DS1 is perpendicular to E. Okay. Now, then according to the definition of electric field, what is the formula? D by E is equal to E DS cos theta. But DS1 and DS2, what is the DS1? AB surface area, DS1 and DS2. These are perpendicular to E. Perpendicular means 90. Then cos 90. Cos 90 is equal to 0. Then D by is equal to 0. What happened? The electric field is not possible from this area. Which area? DS1 and DS2 is not possible. Okay. Now, where is the electric field? The electric field formed, it is an ABCD curved surface of the Gaussian surface. Now, we consider a small area of DS is DS on curved surface, ABCD curved surface. Now, observe. E and DS is parallel to each other. Then E and DS are parallel to each other. E parallel to DS. From the definition of electric plus, then D by is equal to E DS cos theta. Then theta is equal to 0. Theta is equal to 0 means E and DS are parallel to each other. Okay. Now, then theta is equal to 0, cos 0 that is equal to 1. Then D by is equal to E DS. It is only the electric plus is passed into the small area. But we wanted total electric process passing to the total Gaussian surface, Gaussian cylindrical surface. Okay. Now the integration on both sides is equation. Then integration of D by E, then over integration of E by S. Here, derivative integration is cancelled, remaining is over by E. E constant and integration of DS, derivative integration is cancelled. Then pi is equal to ES. It is the total electric plus is passing through the total Gaussian cylindrical surface. Okay. But what about the S? S means surface area of the Gaussian cylindrical surface. What is the formula? S is equal to 2 pi r. Now this value substitution in equation S. Then equation 3, it is substitution in equation 2. Let it is S. Then pi is equal to E into 2 pi r equation 3. But you know, from Gauss law, what is the formula? Pi is equal to Q by epsilon naught. It is the equation number 4. From 3 and 4, we have observed here, pi E, here, pi E, and it is equal to W also equal. Now we can write E into 2 pi r, E into 2 pi r, that is equal to Q by epsilon naught. Okay. Now, what is the limit of definition? What is the formula? Lambda is equal to Q by A. Now, we do cross multiplication. Q is equal to lambda A. The value is substituted here. This is the Q. Then, lambda L by epsilon naught. Q nothing but here. Lambda L. Lambda L by epsilon naught. Here, LL cancel. Now, we get we find the E. Then, E is equal to the total value is upon the lambda by 2 by epsilon. Is the intensity of electric field into infinite charge along y. From this equation, lambda means linear charge density or the radius of the Gaussian cylindrical surface.
Derivative.